Oh, hey there! Have you ever wondered what would happen to me if I were to wear woman's clothes and makeup in the public? Do I deserve to be arrested? Does my right of expression is protected by the federal constitution? Is it true that our law is unequal and discriminate the minority groups? If it's true, then this question shall be answered in this video. One of the most prominent cases that was discussing the issue of equality of the law is the case of Muhammad Juzaili bin Muhammad Khamis against the state government of Negeri Sembilan. This case received the international spotlight because it proved that there are certain laws created unequal and discriminate the minority.
Sir, who is Juzaili?
Can you explain a bit about gender identity disorder?
Gender identity disorder is a medical term to describe humans how are born with hormonal defects that cause them to perceive themselves as the person with certain gender that is contrary to their physical appearance. In this case, Juzaili was naturally born as male but later developed to the desire and perceive himself as a female. This made him to wear and act like female even though he is physically a male. Juzaili's act of cross-dressing caught the attention of Jabatan Agama Islam Negeri Sembilan and caused him to be frequently arrested under the Section 66 of the Syariah Criminal Enactment. Negeri Sembilan, 1992. This section led him to be fined for the offence of posing like woman in the public. This provision criminalised the act of Muslim men who impersonate women by dressing or posing like one. This law was intended to prevent the spreading of HIV, AIDS caused by immoral act of the same gender sexual intercourse that the lawmaker believe will be promoted by the act of cross-dressing.
But one thing about this provision is that it doesn't recognize the existence of the people with gender identity disorder, like Juzaili. This leads to people like Juzaili, who has the kind of disorder, to be discriminated and treated unequally before the law. On 2nd January of 2015, Juzaili brought this issue to the Court of Appeal on Putrajaya after his submission of judicial review was rejected by the High Court of Negeri Sembilan on the basis that the Section 66 Syariah Criminal Enactment Negeri Sembilan 1992 was meant to protect the public rather than fulfilling individual needs. In the Court of Appeal, the Learned Council representing Juzaili stated several statements.
The law violates the Article 9(2) of Federal Constitution because the law itself doesn't guarantee Juzaili's freedom of movement within the Federation. The law caused Juzaili to be restricted from moving freely in the country in fear of being arrested and punished under the law.
Contravene the Article 8(2) of Federal Constitution by being biased to only one gender, as the law itself only applicable to Muslim men who cross-dress without criminalizing the same act done by female Muslim.
The law is inconsistent with Article 8(1) of Federal Constitution, as the law doesn't recognize the male Muslim with gender identity disorder, thus unequally treating them under law. The provision generalizing the Muslim men without the gender identity disorder people into consideration.
The law infringes Juzaili's right to live under the Article 5(1) of Federal Constitution. The provision caused Juzaili to be banned to life his life in a normal manner, as he lives in uncertainty misery and indignity as long as the law exists.
The law is inconsistent with Article 10, Clause 1, where the law itself restricts Juzaili's right of expression of dressing.
As the judgment of the case, the judges of the Court of Appeal decided that the arguments on the appellant side are acceptable and deserve to be given merits. The court ruled out that the Section 66 Sharia Criminal Enactment, Negeri Sembilan 1992, is void and unconstitutional. But, unfortunately, the state government of Negeri Sembilan filed an appeal to the federal court, claiming that the decision of the Court of Appeal was constitutional. The federal court decided that the previous decision ruled out by the Federal Court of Appeal was invalid. This is due to the fact that it is only the power of the federal court to determine whether a law is constitutional or not. But the winning of Mohamed Juzaili during this trial proved that the Malaysian law still protects its civil liberties and upholds the principle of equality. His case was significant as a beacon of hope for the minority in our country to be treated equally before the law.
So, from the case of Mohamed Juzaili, what have we learned about equality? The question that will be asked is, why we need equality in our society? Equality is so important in any kind of society, especially in the society where we have different groups of people. This is to make sure that we recognize every group of people and treat them fairly. There should be no unequal treatment. There should be no bias. Every citizen, Malays, Iban, Indians, Chinese and indigenous should be treated equally and their rights should be protected. If equality is not practiced, social mobility will not be achieved as social progress is slow. There will be groups that forever be oppressed and discriminated. One of the subtle effects of the lack of equality was the unequal treatment to different castes during ancient India. During that time, the society was divided into several different castes, and of course, the lower caste of the society experienced extreme discrimination from the upper caste. They received unequal treatment before the law, thus making them to be less advanced compared to upper caste in terms of wealth collection and education. This made them to be crippled in poverty for generations. Another example is the unequal treatment to the law enacted by the Saudi government. There in the Saudi Arabia, women was banned from driving, and if they were caught doing so, they will be punished severely. This caused females in Saudi Arabia more dependence to their male counterparts as they found it so difficult to travel from one place to another by themselves. So, do our fundamental rights are equally protected in Malaysia? The answer to the question is yes. 1. Federal Constitution stated in Article 8, Clause 1 that we are equal before the law and entitled to equal protection to the law. 2. United Nations Declaration of Human Rights declared that every human is entitled to full equality, to a fair and independent treatment of the legal system in their Article 10. By that, I leave these sessions with a historical footage talking about equality.
I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners, will they be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood? I have a dream. My four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream.